early on when planning a mission or in the early days, a leader ought to be pushing more, demanding more for innovation and new thinking, because if left to simply take the satisfactory or the comfortable, that is probably a pathway to continued policy failure. The very definition of being directed onto an operational crisis conflict setting, some sort of intervention, is that the old solutions and our old policy settings as a national government or as a coalition of governments, they've broken down. New thinking is necessary. It has to be thinking that is grounded in realities of fundamental challenges. They may be demographic, political, environmental, geographic, and so forth, but new thinking.
An important part of innovation is going to be the implementation of what we call the integrated approach. And the integrated approach is effectively ensuring that the effect that we achieve in an operational environment is more than the sum of the individual organisations that deploy. In the past, we've brought very good capabilities into the field, but that's not really enough, because now we're seeing the deployment of military, police, we're seeing aid officials from governments, we're seeing non-government organisations, international organisations, and we're seeing, of course, the full array of local players who are making a contribution to resolving a complex situation. What we need to understand is how we are going to orchestrate all of those effects to achieve the outcomes that we need. And that means a new approach to operations. It means that we don't just bog down in considering things from the perspective, from the institution that we come from, but that we also consider what is required as a collective whole. And sometimes that means giving up your position. It means trading off to ensure that a more collective effect is achieved. The integrated approach is built on establishing strategic alignment at the national policy level. It's built on getting coordination across government and across the various agencies, which means the creation of task forces, pulling on a whole range of expertise and providing people with expertise to lead. It means giving up a degree of positional authority and enabling subject matter experts to have their say and to provide guidance and direction to operations. And in the field, it means that we've got to start thinking about the people we deploy as not being just people from their own agencies, but as a part of a collective team that are there to achieve a response that is going to drive the mission ahead and not only achieve the objectives of this particular operation, but perhaps offset the requirement for future responses.